Hi friend, welcome to GeoEntire. This is again time to share one more video with you. So today I am going to share a video which is based on the what are the different principles of stratigraphy and why stratigraphy is very important. The stratigraphy is important because it helps in the geochronology of geological events as well as to understand the paleoclimatic conditions of the earth. So stratigraphy also helps in correlation of different rock formations which are exposed on the different continents to understand plate tectonic and evolution as well as extinction of the various organisms on the earth. The earlier video I have uploaded on this YouTube, that is the why dinosaurs are extinctions. So these extinctions of various organisms, identification or knowing the conditions, so that's why stratigraphy is very important. Stratigraphy is a mother branch of geology and first step in understanding the earth processes. So that's why stratigraphy is very important. In geology, stratigraphy is very important because to determine the sequence of events in a sedimentary basin. When we see the stratigraphy, it doesn't tell the how old given sedimentary unit, but it tells us the order in which beds were deposited in particular environment or particular area, which is very important if you are trying to find out a particular stratigraphic horizon, such as a carbonate bed that may have the potential to host Mississippi Valley type base metal deposits. If you know where in the stratigraphic sequence that the horizon can be found, and you know where in the sequence you are starting from, you can estimate how far you need to go there to carbonate beds. So there are different principles of stratigraphy that geologists use to find out the history of a rock. So in this video I am going to share 11 principles of stratigraphy. So first we will see, that is the principle of uniformitarianism. This is a principle. It states that the processes that alter the earth's crust are the same processes that occurred millions of years ago. Furthermore, we can say that the results of processes today are the same as the results of the same processes millions of years ago. On this basis of this, we can say that the present is the key to the past, as per the first principle. This means that we can take our observation of processes that occur today and observation of the results and know the process that form it when we see that same result in the rock record. For example, you can look in a particular stream and our ripple marks are the sand, ripple marks in the sand formed by the flow of water over the sand. If you see the ripple marks in the rock record, you can know that the similar processes was at work. So present is the key to the past, according to the principle of uniformitarianism. The second principle, that is the original horizontality. The principle of original horizontality said that the sediments are deposited in a horizontal manner. This is sometimes easier to envision with liquids. Imagine pouring water into a cup. The surface of the water is perfectly flat, horizontal. If you dump that water into a ball, the surface remains flat. Now imagine that you have a jelly mixture in the ball. If you seal it and it solidifies and then pour a different color on top, you have the two flat layers of jelly. On the top of the layer or on the top of the other, this is the similar to how sediment rocks are formed. As water moves sediments from high regions like mountains to low regions like the ocean, the energy of the system decreases until the sediments are deposited in the basin like a lake or an ocean. More sediments is deposited on top, and over time the whole sequence lithifies or short like the jelly did in the fridge. The rocks remain horizontal until a force are on them, pushing for pulling them out of the original orientation. Then third principle, that is the order of superposition or superposition. This principle said that sequence of the rocks in their original orientation will have the oldest rock at the bottom and new at the top, or youngest rock on the top. A simple way to think about this is that the something to be on the top of something else. For example, in order to put a book on the top of a table, the table has to be there. If the table isn't already there and you put the book down, it falls to the floor, and the floor had to be there for the book on the land on it. The same is the true of rocks. In order to deposit a sandstone on the top of limestone, the limestone has already to be there. Knowing this, geologists can figure out the relative ages of the rocks on the top of each other. So this is the order of superposition, or we can say that the principle of superposition. This is the third principle, which is very, very important. So according to this principle, the oldest rock at the bottom and new at the top. Then fourth principle, that is called as cross-cutting relationship. Similarly to the principle of superposition, a rock must already to be placed to be cut by the fault, igneous intrusion or erosion. By carefully examining which rock units are cut by faults or intrusion, or which rock units have been weathered, geologists can further determine the relative ages of the rocks. So therefore, this is the fourth principle, that is cross-cutting relationship, that is also very, very important. Fifth principle, Walter's law. According to the Walter's law, it is different from the previous discussed principles, but it is just and important. Instead of dealing only with the relative time, Walter's law deals with the relative space through the time. Walter's law states that the depositional environments that are already adjacent on the surface of the earth will also appear in succession in a stratigraphic sequence. If there is something missing, there is a missing time or an unconformity. So that is the Walter's law. This is the fifth principle in stratigraphy. Then sixth principle, that is the principle of inclusion. The principle of inclusions state that inclusions found on the other rocks or formations must be older than the rock that contain them. This is actual pure logic, and it can be applied not only in geology, but it is also especially very useful for the geologist. Seventh principle, that is the principle of faunal succession. The principle of faunal succession, also known as the law of faunal succession, it is based on the observation that sedimentary rock strata contain fossilized flora and fauna, and that these fossils succeed each other vertically in a specific reliable order that can be identified over wide horizontal distances. That is the seventh principle. Then eighth principle, that is the base level. Base level is the level below which erosion cannot occur or cannot taken place, and above which deposition does not taken place. Sea level is the ultimate base level of the erosion. Lakes and reservoirs provide temporary base level. Change in the sea level can be relative. Changes in the sea level create and destroy accommodation space. Base level is the primary factor determining the erosion versus deposition. So that's why this base level is the eighth principle of stratigraphy. Then ninth principle, that is the incomplete record. Incomplete record, the rock record consists of punctuated depositional events such as floods, storms and turbidity flows separated by a gap or unconformity, we can say that. So that is the incomplete record. Then 10th principle, that is the principle of accommodation. Sediment accumulation is limited by amount of space available below base level. So this is referred to accommodation space. The amount of accommodation is determined by a combination of eustatic sea level fluctuation and basin subsidence, and can be positive or negative. The rate and direction of accumulation change has a strong impact on the nature and geometry of sedimentary packages. So this is the 10th principle of the stratigraphy. Then last principle, that is the preservation potential. Preservation potential, it refers to the likelihood of sedimentary deposits to both accumulate and to be saved as part of the stratigraphic record. Preservation is affected by a depositional environment, position in the graded profile, tectonic setting and phase with an eustatic cycle. So these are the 11 principles which are very, very important to know the better stratigraphy. So on the basis of these 11 principles, stratigraphy is based on these 11 principles. So I hope this video is useful to you. If you like my video, share and subscribe my YouTube channel, that is GeoEntire, all about the earth.